Okay, guys, what's Gucci? It's Santana, and I'm back with another video today. Sine is at school. Almost every video that I do alone, just know she's probably in school. But right now, we're about to get into a little music. Hold on, I gotta check. Just make sure my stuff is recording, because I would hate to have this mic on and it's not doing its job, its purpose, okay? Today, I'm really, really excited to do this video. I've always wanted to do something similar to this, but I never knew how to do it, what to call it. But I watched a couple of videos, which was actually not planned. And it was about, I don't remember the two YouTubers I watched, so I linked in the description so you guys can check them out. But basically, they both were just breaking down their playlists and going through like all of their playlists, highlighting like two or three songs from each, like, oh, get into this, get into that. But basically, this is just me like showing you guys a little bit of my music and kind of like shamelessly promoting my playlist and my Spotify. So definitely get into that. So I changed my Spotify name. So if you watched any previous videos where we do like playlists, I usually include like my Spotify. But I changed it. It's not Ultra Butterfly anymore. It's Santana. S-A-N-T-A-N-U-H. So it's like the phonetic spelling of it. But like, yeah, let me just get into it because I'm kind of rambling and I really want to jump right into this and not make this video too long. So I'm looking at my Spotify playlist, the first one or my most recently made one, which is called Look Me in the Eye. And just like my little description for it is like R&B jams that make me feel like I'm in the middle of a party and spot my soulmate. I know that kind of sounds corny, and I think with these playlists I really allow myself to be corny, to be as imaginative as possible, because when I hear songs, I don't know if everyone does this, but I like process the song and like really imagine myself in a different environment. Like I really zone out and I literally just make a whole video, see myself in a movie with this song. Like music really, really is something that I cherish a lot. And yeah, that's why I'm like super excited to film this video. But okay, so Look Me in the Eye is a playlist I just made like 6 days ago. It says right here. So when I listened to some of the songs, I was like, this sounds more like you're in a party, LED lights are on, lights are off, no phones in sight. This is my imagination. You're dancing, talking to your friends or whoever you came with. Boom. At the door, you see your soulmate. And you're like, and he or she or they look at you, right? And you're like, and then it's like they're walking to you. And it's like slow-mo. And they're like, what's your name? I want to get to know you a little bit. And these are the songs I imagine to be playing in the background, okay? So, we're gonna just, I'm gonna play like three songs that I really like from this playlist that you guys should get into, but I'm definitely gonna like tell you guys, please take your time to listen to this whole playlist through. I add constantly to it, 99 songs, 6 hours and 16 minutes. It's gonna definitely get longer, but yeah, that's my little spill on that. I'm kind of talking a long time, so I'm gonna keep it shorter for like the other playlist, but let's see which ones I would like to play for y'all. Because what? Oh, okay, so Who Hurt You by Daniel Caesar with the background vocals of T-Pain. Okay,
Georgia, back to Atlanta. Honey, how present turns past. I'm a fly Priscilla.
Okay, we're gonna keep it at that because I don't want to get copyrighted for this. But like that vibe right there. Okay, so I'll just do one more song from this playlist. Okay, this is my favorite song as of right now. Always and Forever, Mariah the Scientist featuring Lil Baby. So I'll just play a little snippet.
Baby,
Oh my god, like, someone please, like, when COVID's over and I have a party. Okay, I'm talking about have a party, but I don't really be partying like that. But if I was, this song is being played. I don't care if anyone, if everyone sits down, like, what? This song is just good. Okay. On to the main character playlist. I'm pretty sure you or someone has told you about, like, main character music. If you have TikTok, you probably see main character type TikToks. Or if you have YouTube, I mean, you're on YouTube. But if you've seen, like, videos on YouTube where they do, like, main character vibey playlist type videos, hence this and why I created it. But it was at first called Santana's Production, like a movie soundtrack. But it kind of looked corny, and I just like main character. So, basically, it's a soundtrack dedicated to my dream teen angst-filled movie. So, all of these songs on this playlist make me feel like I'm in a coming-of-age movie, okay? Just graduated high school, trying to figure out my life, find the love of my life, and find, you know, something that's going to make me happy with my life by the end of the movie, right? So these are all songs that basically make me feel like this. So you got a little bit of songs from, like, the Euphoria soundtrack, a lot of Tove Lo, not a lot, but, you know, quite a few songs, a lot of Lorde. Especially from Pure Heroine, like her first album, that's amazing. Get into that, please. Billie Eilish, a lot of The Neighborhood, a little bit of The 1975, Florence and the Machine, Foster the People. Like, yeah, I just have a nice little range of people. Hozier, like, it's a pretty good, like, playlist. I'm kind of proud of this one too, because it just makes me feel so, like, I'm done with you, Mom. Like, and, you know, run out, run away. While I run away, I, like, find someone on, like, the side of the road, and we start a life together, you know? That's what I imagine these songs. I would never do that, but if I was to, like, these would be the songs that I would be hearing. Okay, we're gonna play this. Glory and Gore. The calculation. Break. And the cry goes out. Oh. Like, do you hear that? The vocals. And if I'm correct, she was like 18 when she made this album. So, like, what? I'm 19. I could never produce something like that. Like, what? And then we're gonna play this Worst Nights by Foster the People. It's about to hit. Wait. Oh my god, like, first of all, this song is not sad, but it's like one of those, oh, I'm at the party, I go to a club I'm not supposed to in the movie, and I'm like, hey, all my worst nights, all the best time. Like, please listen to this, please listen to my main character playlist if you don't listen to anything else, because I put a lot of work into this, because I had to sit there on my bed and be like, what am I running around to this song? Am I drinking when I'm not supposed to be drinking to this song in the back? Like, I think so hard with these playlists, I promise you. Okay, Early Morning is one of my favorite ones too. I'm gonna say that about everything probably. Can just please stop overheating. Oh my god. Okay. Early Morning, songs that you listen to when the sun rises. Songs that will be perfect to start your day with. I have 104 songs and this is 6 hours and 11 minutes. So basically, the title self-explanatory, Early Morning, listen to this in the morning. I don't like to start my day off with anything, like, too loud, like, screaming, shouting. And even, like, soulful singers who, like, like, I don't want to hear that in the morning. I want to hear, like, very mellow, jazz-infused type music. Like, I got a little bit of Lauryn Hill, a lot of Jhené Aiko. A lot of Jhené Aiko. A little bit of Kehlani, lots of Khalid. Like, Khalid's album, Free Spirit. Ooh. Free Spirit is definitely on this joint. Like, once I hear this, I usually feel very motivated to do a lot of my homework. I do most of my homework in the morning too, or like classwork. So listening to this while I'm getting ready for the day, it's just, I don't know, it just does something to me. So like, I'm gonna play two songs, you know, gotta do that for this one. We're gonna play River by Umi. My computer is just like going through right now. Okay, like, and it's, she'd be like, rivers running deep. I don't know why I'm singing like I can, but, okay, one more. Thoughts on, I always mess that up. I say thoughts in a balcony, and I know it's Thoughts from a Balcony by Mac Miller. I'm late to the train on this. I know this song is like 7 years old, but better late than never. This one makes me feel like I'm feeling motivated. I don't know if that makes sense, but I be listening to this feeling like, let me get my notepad. Let me write a little bit. It is a little upbeat, but just like once I'm fully awake. Reality coupling. Let me get a one-way ticket. The lay man, y'all. I got an army right in front of me. I'm gangsta gone. Yes, me against the world. I guess I'll take them on. I might stop and see my girl, but I ain't staying long. What if I'm gone? What the fuck? Yes, please listen to that. Like, it's really good, y'all. Really, really good. Like, good vibes. This song, just good. So, on to the summer vibes. It's kind of giving the same vibe as early morning, but these are a little more upbeat. So, like, songs I imagine here are, like, the beach or summer kickback. Obviously, we shouldn't be at any kickbacks. I created this in January of this year. So, I was hoping for, like, you know, vacations. I was hoping for beach trips, even though I don't go to the beach. But, you know, these are kind of, like, eh. Like, I look at these songs, sometimes I'd be like, okay, I'm gonna play this. Get You, but the Miguel cover. Through drought and famine, natural disaster, my baby has been around for me. Every time I look into your eyes, I see. You're all I need. If you've seen Aquamarine, the movie, it came out like 2006, stars JoJo, and I forgot her name, and Emma Roberts. You may have heard this song. I don't know. When I ask people, have they heard the song? They're like, no, I never heard that song. That song's boring. But it's Island in the Sun by Weezer. Let me stop rambling. Roller skating. You're with your friends at a skating rink, just vibing. And this is like basically what I said. Like, when I hear these songs, I'm roller skating. I'm not doing anything else. I'm just roller skating. And the roller rinks never play what I want to hear. So like, why not make a playlist for what I want to hear when I go roller skating? And the picture, that's the cover, is actually from Euphoria. Don't know what episode, but it's when Rue, Jules, and Lexi go to the roller rink and have, like, a nice little good time, you know what I'm saying? Oh, my computer's still overheating. Okay, so we're gonna play one song from this playlist, but, like, a lot of, cool jams. I don't know if there's, like, one specific artist on this, though. Okay, Bruno Mars seems to be popping up. Khalid, Claro. Is it ever gonna change? Am I gonna feel this way forever? Paramore's on this joint. Tam Impala, Destiny Rogers, Blood Orange. Yeah, get into this. Okay, I'm gonna play one song because this is my joint by Foster. by Foster the People as well. You heard them when I played Worst Nights. This is peak roller skating music. And if you can't see yourself roller skating to this song, what? Like, your imagination must be off, okay? Let me stop. It's not. I'm dead. You gotta listen to that whole thing. And when you listen to it, put headphones in, close your eyes maybe, and just roller skate. Come over here, sit next to me. Okay, Late Night Drive. I think one of the ones that has like the most songs the longest time. This is the playlist you'll listen to when you're in your feelings, riding around at midnight, or even falling in love. I need to take that out because that's kind of corny. But I mean, it's very on theme for myself right now. But basically, I imagine all of these songs in the car. Like, they sound amazing in the car. Like, they sound great when you listen to them regularly. But in the car with the bass bumping, with the lights out. Like, lights out. When it's dark outside. Like, it's just something to you. Like, it just does it. Do I want to play something from this? I feel like I should because this is like... Okay, so this is still... This is now under construction. Because I'm trying to, you know, get everything to fit its vibe. And some of this stuff has, like, not fit the vibe at all. So we're going to just play this one song and move on. Everyone should know this song, but I'm going to put you on if you don't know. Love Song, Rihanna, Future. Sounding too desperate. Okay, yeah, we're gonna skip through some of these playlists because it's kind of taking a long time and we almost had 30 minutes, y'all. Fall playlist. These songs make me feel like the beginning of fall, huh? So when I hear these songs, I'm raking my leaves. I'm drinking Starbucks. I'm putting on a fur coat. Like, these are the songs that you hear. Got a little bit of Justin Bieber. Lots of Florence and the Machine in here. Khalid, Andrea Day, Alicia Keys, Miguel. But when I tell you a lot of Florence and the Machine, it's a lot. Georgia Smith, Rex Orange County. Don't know why I can't talk. Why is this song in here? Hold up. Sorry, I gotta delete that joint. I was listening to this earlier, this playlist, because I usually do this. See, great playlist to listen to when you're studying or coloring. Also, there are some songs that have lyrics. Don't be mad at me. I think I've taken most of the songs with actual, like, verses out. But, yeah, it's, like, usually background music from... That's not really how I should say it, but it's more so, like, the instrumentals behind songs. Behind movies and TV shows. So, like, the score. There you go. I have, like, the score from this show called Pitch on Fox that got canceled after the first season, okay? I got a lot of Lindsay Sterling, okay? Lots of that from her. A little bit of Vitamin String Quartet, Beethoven. I got the Flight of the Bumblebee in this joint. A little bit of Carlos Santana, Jimi Hendrix, just, like, his guitar playing. That sounds ugly. I don't like how I said that. The Theorist, he does, like, popular songs and does, like, a piano arrangement. Ludwig Göransson, the score of the Black Panther movie. I got some score music from a bunch of TV shows, basically, and movies that I like, and yeah, the oldies. And I had to make it a point to say I took 2 hours to arrange these songs in the right year order, so please listen with appreciation. 171 songs, 12 hours and 52 minutes. So I had to rearrange 171 songs. I know Beyonce is not oldies, and I know it's Eddie James who's saying All I Could Do Was Cry, and I'd Rather Go Blind, but I just like her version. No offense to Miss James, okay? That's the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more videos like this. Also, follow me on Spotify at san-tan-uh. And let me know your favorite songs from either this playlist that I kind of highlighted, or give me some songs I should add to my playlist. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed again, and have a nice one.
Thank you.